As a developer, you'll sometimes want to engage in a more conversational style of exchange. Request-response is a simple yet versatile messaging pattern that facilitates bidirectional exchanges in an asynchronous framework. As shown in this video, we often illustrate this messaging pattern with a requesting application putting its request onto a static queue and creating a temporary dynamic queue to receive its responses at. This is just one way to carry out the exchange. So let's look at some variations on this already versatile messaging pattern. By using a static queue for the responses as well as the request, you can ensure your responses will persist even in the event of a queue manager restart. It also means that we can have multiple request responder pairs using a single queue, which is useful for promoting more administrative control over that queue. For topic-based solutions, request response can even be implemented just using topics. The requesting application will publish its request to a topic. This request contains the name of the topic to which responding applications need to send their reply, and the requesting application must be subscribed to this in order to receive its response. Subscribers of the request topic will receive the request and will be able to publish their responses to the response topic specified in the request message. By having both request and response messages going to topics, it means that we can have multiple copies of our message, one for each subscription to the topic. You might want to do this if you want to prompt multiple people to carry out an action and then collect responses from them all. So this might be a travel agent coordinating bookings with flights, hotels, and excursion providers for a particular customer. The travel agent would only need to send the request out once to one topic, which would send it out to all the subscribers. These subscribers could then all send their responses to a single topic, subscribed to by the travel agent. You might also choose to combine topics and queues, and one way to do this would be to have the requesting application publish its request to a topic and specify a queue to receive its responses at. This would enable the request to be sent out to multiple responders and for all the responses to be collected on a single queue. You might apply this to a scenario where you need to collect and process applications on a first-come, first-served basis. This opportunity would be advertised on a topic and copies would be sent to all the subscribers. These subscribers would then submit their applications to the queue specified. Since messages are consumed FIFO from a queue, the requester can process these applications in the order that they arrive. This combination of destinations also has its applications in IoT scenarios, for example in a supermarket. The supermarket manager might only want to know if at least one till is open, so it would publish its request to a topic and specify that the responses go to a temporary dynamic queue. Then, once a single message confirming that a till is open is received, the requesting application can disconnect from the queue manager, deleting the response queue. We can also put requests to a queue and specify a topic that we want our responses published to. If we look at this in an event planning scenario, a request to plan an event would come onto the queue, which an event coordinator would pick up. They could then send a message to a topic subscribed to by multiple vendors to prompt them to offer their services. These vendors might then initiate their own request response interactions. In this video, we had a look at just some of the ways that we could adapt request response for a range of different use cases. But the scenarios covered here are by no means exhaustive, so be sure to play around with variations to suit your needs.